even really uses email anymore.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Telltale Rum Club here on the Corky's Earl channel. I'm Corky, as always. This is Alex and I were talking about a whole bunch of stuff, but that leads me to the fact that Alex is back.
Hey, it's been a while.
So, not for us. But we were talking about the whole Pokemon Go controversy, and I'm sure it'll come back. But we're back playing the game now, so we're playing Feud. Let's get back to it.
We just walked in the house after jumping over that fence and looking at the treehouse.
Damn. Just touched that bowl of fruit. Alex was talking about all the controversy that's been going on with Pokemon Go and how on... We looked right at it!
His knee is hurt. I think that's his deal. Is he was limping earlier when he first got out of the car. I think his... Yeah, he's limping.
Yeah, it's like cut. But that's still bullshit because we looked right at the puddle.
I'm like, yeah, and what kind of an idiot, when there's that much gap around the sides, walks straight through the blood?
Do I need to, like... Is there subtitles on this?
I don't know. That'd be helpful because we keep talking over him.
I know. Settings?
Just so shoddy audio. Because sometimes he'll just talk the whole time and other times he's just, like, is random about it.
No, there's no... Unless it's in gameplay, which would be weird to put... Yeah, alright.
Which Corey subtitles on. Corky likes to sing every time he talks, you know, in his life, but most normal people, they don't actually talk to themselves when no one else is around. Which always makes me kind of laugh when games do that. I'll explain the obvious.
Yeah.
I guess just to share extra information with the player, but it's still funny.
Because even me, like, if I was walking around this house, it'd be inner monologue. It wouldn't be like, yeah. Oh man, I should probably avoid that puddle.
Or grab these gun shells. We should have grabbed that shotgun. Just about anything
worthwhile is gone. Oh, awesome.
Maybe those weren't gun shells. Although there is a thing of knives right there.
But now I can turn this down. There are three new messages. Okay, so that means we need to be, like, looking for the... Oh, here we go. Cup of water. How long's that been sitting there, dude?
Probably somebody's spit cup.
Those, the subtitles for...
I'm sure in all that there's some crackers, there's something.
Yeah, like
all that food up there. This is peanut butter.
This is all something we could be taking or eating or something. But granted, we don't know when the last time this dude ate was.
Yeah,
so he might not be hungry.
He was just arrested like an hour ago, tops. So.
And that's what we assume, like. He might have been, like, in a holding cell or something, and being transferred, not, you know.
Not just arrested at the site.
We'll take that, though.
It's a curious thing, keeping your silverware drawer.
It's weird that he just held it up to his face for a while. I don't know. Like, emergency walkie-talkie in the drawer, and then you keep the other one, like, upstairs or something? Where's the phone? Because I've heard
you
that...
You keep hearing messages on the wall.
Yeah. Was it on the wall?
No. Well,
oh, here we go.
Imagine. Yeah, that's kind of an old-fashioned thing.
Alright, here we go.
You're during your messages. Please pass the spaghetti.
Yeah, this is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day.
That's because he's a zombie!
Promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Is this the ambulance?
Why do I keep drinking my coffee? Whoa. What about what?
I wonder if this is the same ambulance that came up on the radio and passed us in the cop car.
Ambulance.
Ambulance.
Somebody call ambulance.
Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
All right, so that's the mom. Message 3.
Talking to the husband, who's probably at the house somewhere dead, so we need to watch out for that.
No, so what this is the mom and dad of Clementine, who's the girl that is in this house.
That we probably saw on the ridge up there.
Exactly. They went out of town and left her with a babysitter, who is Diana. Clem's dad got bit, and the mom, you know, stayed with him and couldn't get back. And then I assume the babysitter...
is bitten.
Mm-hmm.
And hiding for us in a closet or under the bed. Or behind the barbecue grill. Be quiet.
And that's... assumably Clementine talking to us right now.
So she's probably upstairs, like you said.
Here's a choice.
Are you okay?
I'm okay. They tried to get me. But I'm hiding until my parents come home.
And it's, like, already, like, tugging at our heartstrings that we know her parents are not coming home.
Yeah. What's your name?
What's your name?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee.
Now we have a name for our character.
How old are you?
How old are you?
8.
And you're all alone?
Oh, Joe.
Yes. I don't know where anybody is. How old are you?
I'm, 37.
Predator alert.
Okay.
Where are your parents?
Where are your parents?
Shouldn't have said that.
They took a trip and left me with Sandra.
They're in Savannah, I think. Where the boats are?
Are you safe?
There you go.
Safe?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
Because they can't climb ladders.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
It's a friendly little kid, which is nice.
Mm-hmm. The game? I was like, did the game freeze? Alright, there's the babysitter.
There's Sandra. How you doing?
What are you doing? Hey? Oh, I gotta mash it. Alright, here we go. A and then B.
Snapper net. Oh, throw her into the stuff. Kick her. Don't kick her. Should have kicked her.
That's the second time we slipped on that blood.
And that blood, that's not even where the blood was in that spot. Like, how do you slip on that? And then run into the counter that it's next to.
Remember that blood I tripped on 7 times? I tripped on it again. Uh-oh.
So this time I fell and hit my head, so now I'm going to be limping around some more. Complaining about neck pains.
Alright, here we go. Oh, nothing is happening right now.
Tell Clementine to grab what she's holding. She's got a hammer? Man, I love this kid already. Face. Right in front of the little kid. That's, I don't know, good or bad, maybe.
I know, I'm like,
use your ethic.
Woof.
Tell the kid to get back in the treehouse would be a bad idea.
Looking pretty rough.
Man. Hi there.
Did you kill it?
Don't slip on the blood. I think so.
I don't know. I think so.
Sometimes they come back.
Yeah, I'm like, if we slip on this blood walking out of this house, I'm gonna lose my shit.
But they get shot a lot.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
What do we do? There, I'm like,
for help until it gets dark.
We need to find help before it gets dark.
They were both essentially the same things.
No, one was saying, let's wait until dark and then let's leave. Another one was saying, let's go look for help until it gets dark. And then, I assume, go hide out in the clubhouse where it's safe for now. And then regroup in the morning and come up with a game plan and make a little adventure.
I guess we'll see.
I'm like, though seemingly irresponsible to take an 8-year-old girl with you, you know, while you go venture the neighborhood where all these rest of the zombies are.
She might know the neighborhood better than us, though.
Yeah, and she knows apparently more about the zombies than we do.
About the Zambos. Look at pool cover.
It's a nice pool cover.
That's a nice
pool. Really not. It's all
maybe I'll just go for a dip, is what he just said. Fuck out of here.
Wouldn't be a bad idea to get out all your bloody clothing. I'm sure her dad's got clothes in the house.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, probably could have changed.
Oh, man.
Uh-oh.
I ain't never getting home to mom at this rate. This sucks.
Did you do run into another car?
It's hot dish night.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
Leave one of the walkie-talkies.
What do we
do? They won't. Let's go. Ah, that was bad.
We should go.
Then they'll find me, right?
I won't leave you alone, okay?
Alex immediately regret.
You don't want to tell a little kid, your parents aren't coming home, sorry, deal with it.
They won't. Ah, God.
Holy shit.
Don't eat us.
I hurt you. Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both going to give us the chomp.
Give us the chomp.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Trying to get home. This neighborhood's a disaster.
Are you trying get out of town.
Because you should be.
Because you should be.
I haven't seen anything as gnarly as this neighborhood since downtown Atlanta, 15 miles back.
Downtown Atlanta, where Rick wakes up.
This is Clementine.
That's incorrect. That's not where Rick wakes up.
I'm Chet.
He's in Georgia, right?
He is in Georgia, yeah, and then he goes to Atlanta because he hears that's where people are. And they're not, remember? It's like that whole fucking, like, he has to hide in the tank.
Oh, yeah. That's where the little Chinese kid is, the favorite character.
I'm her babysitter. Glenn, the Chinese kid,
yeah.
He pops it in this.
Yeah. Oh, does he really?
Yeah.
That's awesome. He was my favorite.
Staying put for too long.
And his old girlfriend.
Maggie.
Wife.
Michonne got her own little one of these.
Her own telltale?
Yeah, where it like explains what happens with her and her like boyfriend and baby in depth.
Her two zombie lovers. Trying to help them push.
I keep thinking like I should move with the left thumbstick, but it's like touch things with the right. Am I doing?
Hey, little girl, come to our rescue.
Yeah, I'm like Clementine coming to help. That's far enough, right?
Yeah, it's a pickup. Come on now.
Everybody, I'm Chet.
As babysitters go, I'd say her parents owe you a tip.
There's a road. There's nothing blocking it.
So guys, that wraps up episode 2. So,
man.
Yeah. Alex is new to this whole game, so he will get into the whole groove of timing episodes and stuff. But guys, thanks so much for tuning in. Thanks for Alex for being here and playing this with me.
Yeah.
And we will see you. Oh, well. Be good to yourself, be good to each other, and we will see you in the next episode. Later days, guys.
See ya.